Another developing story that we've been tracking, Afghanistan. Now, when terrorists talk of peace, you must be wary because chances are a bigger game is afoot. In Afghanistan, that's what the Taliban is doing. They razed districts to the ground, murdered soldiers in cold blood, and now they want a ceasefire. Not a permanent one, but more of a pause, a ceasefire deal for 3 months. That's what the Taliban have offered the Afghan government. Seems a bit fishy, doesn't it? Until yesterday, they were on the charge, running over districts and border posts every day. So what has changed now? You see, this ceasefire is not for the Afghan people. It is for the Taliban to regroup. In return for the ceasefire, the Taliban have two demands. Number one, release 7,000 insurgents who are in Afghan prisons. And number two, Taliban leaders must be crossed off from a United Nations blacklist. Now, these are serious demands, big demands, almost too big for any government to accept. But Kabul is debating it. On the one hand, 3 months of badly needed peace. On the other, giving the Taliban exactly what they want. It's a tough one. In 3 months, the Taliban can consolidate their gains. They can fortify the districts they've taken, and the Afghan army will just have to stand by and watch. Because a ceasefire means no counterinsurgency operations. It's a classic military strategy, quitting when you're ahead, or in this case, pausing when you're ahead. Here's the other problem, 7,000 insurgents on the loose. That's what the Taliban wants. It's almost like a deja vu. Last year, the Afghan government released 5,000 Taliban prisoners, and yet there was no peace. Those released prisoners just ended up back on the battlefield. So the Afghan government has a big decision to make here. If they accept the ceasefire, the Taliban will consolidate. They will return after 3 months, and this time with 7,000 more fighters in their ranks. But if they don't accept, they will have to continue fighting a losing battle. And don't underestimate the allure of peace, especially for a country that has been at war for 20 years. So what happens if Kabul accepts? For the United States, it would be great news. 3 months is perfect for them to wind up their operations, to evacuate their local allies from Afghanistan. Who are these allies? Mostly Afghan interpreters. Almost 18,000 of them who helped America over 20 years. Add their families, and that's almost 80,000 people, 80. They have to be evacuated, 80,000 people, and settled in the United States. In typical American style, they have given a name for this operation. Operation Allies Refuge. It will start by the last week of July. First, the interpreters will be flown to a third country. Here, they will wait for their U.S. visa to be cleared, and then they'll take another flight to the United States. It sounds fairly easy on paper. But who will host these 80,000 Afghans? The U.S. is looking at options in Central and South Asia, and these countries are playing hardball, understandably so. They're being forced to clear up America's mess. Why would they? The biggest problem for these neighbors is the Taliban's arrival at their borders. Even for the likes of Pakistan, it's a challenge. On Wednesday, the Taliban claimed to have captured the border post of Spin Boldak on the Afghanistan-Pakistan border. This is where the post is. Today, this is what it looks like. Hundreds of people tried to breach the border. Pakistani troops had to fire tear gas and shut the border to disperse them. So who exactly were these people and what were they trying to do here? You see, Spin Boldak links Afghanistan with Balochistan. The Taliban's leadership has been based here for decades. Plus, there are reserve Taliban fighters in the province. They frequently cross over to Afghanistan. What we saw today is just a sample of what could be in store. Both Central and South Asia are on notice here for infiltrations and for exodus. And this problem will likely be discussed in Uzbekistan today. That's where the leaders of Central and South Asia are meeting for a connectivity conference. Afghan President Ashraf Ghani is there. Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan is also there. They're both in Tashkent. Also in attendance is India's External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar. Central Asia will be key in the Afghan churn. For starters, refugees are already crossing over. More than 300 of them fled to Tajikistan in 2 days. Most of them girls trying to escape the Taliban's diktats. 20 years back, these Central Asian borders were volatile. There was open hostility between the Taliban and Central Asian governments. Now there's fear of a repeat. And to make matters worse, world powers are descending. America is wooing Central Asia, possibly to secure a military base there. As you would expect, Russia is livid. But the terrorists at the center of this chaos are on a winning streak. On the battlefield, they have the upper hand. And now they have boxed in Kabul with an impossible offer. Temporary peace at the cost of a war tomorrow. WION is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.